How to add two-factor authentication to your Google account. Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Here's a question I got just recently. My biggest challenge thus far is how to use from start to finish the two-step authentication process as I fail to understand how to use the black square, unsure of the technological term, that requires you to set up either by taking a picture of it or what? To move on to the next step. Okay, the black square, as you call it, is more properly referred to as a QR code. QR stands for quick response. And while we don't actually take a picture, we will use the camera on a mobile device to set up Google Authenticator compatible two-factor authentication by looking at it. Let's walk through those steps. There are a couple of prerequisites that I want to make sure are in place. In order to set up this type of two-factor authentication, you'll need the following: a smartphone with a camera, the Google Authenticator or a compatible app installed on that smartphone, and then an account that supports Google Authenticator compatible authentication. Now, the example I'm going to use here, of course, is a Google account, so the last item kind of a given. The process with accounts from any other provider that supports this type of two-factor authentication is very similar. All right, what do? Well, sign into your Google account. You can see here I'm in my Google account for my AskLeo test account. What you'll do is click on your profile icon and then click on Manage Your Google Account. On the next page, click on Security. Now, scroll down to something that says how you sign into Google. So as you can see, for this account, I've actually got quite a few. It's my test account, so I'm trying everything. But the bottom line here is that this is where you need to go. Now you'll notice that there is no Google Authenticator listed. Well, you can add more sign-in options down at the bottom of the list, and of course we click on Authenticator. Now you may be asked to sign in again, just to confirm that you're you, since we're about to do something that is important for security. Now, make sure you've got the Google Authenticator app installed on your phone. Here, we click on Set Up Authenticator. And now we see the QR code. This is the QR code that we'll be using. Now, we're not going to take a picture of it as much as we're going to use the app to look at it. Now, I'm going to recommend you might want to take a screenshot of this QR code. I'll talk more about that in a minute. But now you reach for your smartphone. Open the Google Authenticator app. Click on the plus at the bottom right. Now, as you can see, I already have an existing account present in this authenticator. It can handle as many different accounts as you need. On the next screen, click on Scan a QR code. That's what we're doing. Now, the Authenticator app will turn on the camera and give you a rectangle on the screen. Point the camera at the QR code on your computer screen. Basically, try and center it or get it inside of that square. As soon as the app focuses the camera and decodes that QR code, it will instantly return to the initial screen and display the newly added authentication code. You can see here that we just added askleotest@gmail.com. That was all encoded in that QR code. That's how the Authenticator app got the information and got the information to be able to provide that six-digit number you see that's going to be changing every 30 seconds. All right, back to your computer. We'll click on Next. I will type in the six-digit number that is currently being displayed by the app and click on Verify. Boom! We've just added two-factor authentication to this Google account. You can see here it just says your authenticator. You can change the Authenticator app later if you want to, or you can get rid of it, but you've added it. And in fact, if we go back to the list of how you sign in, you'll see that Authenticator is right here. And if you need to make a change, you can make a change. All right. What if you don't have a camera? Or what if your camera's not working? It's not common, but it happens. As it turns out, there's an alternative approach. So I'm going to go ahead and delete this authenticator right now because I'm not going to be using it. And I'm going to set up an authenticator again. Now, you can see here that there is this link that says can't scan it. Click on that. Now you'll get this long, horrible, random string of text. That's the same information that was in the QR code. That's the information that allows you to associate your authenticator app with the application or the service you're signing into. If you can't scan the QR code, then there's almost always a way to manually type in a code like this. Once you do so, you're done. You'll have two-factor authentication set up yet again. It will go through the process of confirming that you've entered it properly and having you enter a code, but the net result will be exactly the same as if you had used a QR code. You can see, though, why using a QR code might be a little bit easier if you can at all possibly do it. All right. Now, we've got our phone now is set up with the Google Authenticator app as our two-factor authentication. The next time you sign into this Gmail account on a new device, it will ask you not only for your username and your password, but also for the code that's currently being displayed in the authenticator. Enter that code properly, and you're signed into your account. And you should never have to use the authenticator again on that specific browser and machine until or unless you clear cookies. What happens if you lose your phone? If you need your phone to sign in, what happens if you lose it? There are a bunch of approaches to this. And honestly, it's not a huge issue. But I want to give you something that honestly is something that I've been doing for a long time and just gives me that sense of security and safety that honestly, if I lose my phone, it really doesn't matter. Here's what we do. We save the QR code or that long text string at setup time. For example, when the QR code is displayed, take a screenshot, save that somewhere. Go ahead and click on Can't Scan It and save a copy of the displayed key. I happen to do both. Now, if your phone is lost, you'd replace it. You'd set up the Google Authenticator app again, but this time you would not go through the entire process we just did. This time you would simply scan the QR code that you had saved or enter the code that you had saved from when you set it up in the first time. And to be clear, this technique also allows you to set up multiple devices. You can have two phones and have them both scan the same QR code. They're going to display the same six-digit code if they've scanned the same QR code. Now, I want to be clear. This stuff that you save, the QR code or that text string, is sensitive information. Anyone with access to these codes could set up two-factor authentication for your account. So, make certain to save them securely. Personally, I put them in the notes field of my password vault. But honestly, any other secure approach is fine. Just make sure they're not accessible to those who shouldn't have access. Bottom line, use two-factor authentication. It's one of the best ways to secure your account against hacking. Using the process above, you can now do so using Google Authenticator compatible two-factor authentication. For links, for updates, for comments, and more, visit askleo.com/175329. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.